Hello everyone, welcome back to the gRPC course. In this lecture, we will learn about gRPC reflection and how to use Evans client to play with it. gRPC reflection is an optional extension for the server to assist client to construct requests without having to generate stubs beforehand. This is very useful for clients to explore the gRPC API before actually going into implementation. Let's start by adding the gRPC reflection to the Golang server. As you can see here, it's super simple. We just need to import the reflection package and call reflection.register. So let's do it. In our server main.go file, after register the laptop service, we call reflection.register and pass in the gRPC server. And that's it. How about Java? It's also pretty straightforward. We have to add the gRPC service dependency to our project, and then add the proto reflection service to the server. Let's go to Maven repository and search for gRPC service. Let's copy this Gradle setting and paste it to the build.gradle file. Wait a bit for IntelliJ IDEA to update. Then we go to laptopserver.java file. In this constructor, after adding the laptop service to the server, we just add a new instance of the proto reflection service. And voila, the gRPC reflection is enabled on the server. Next step, we will install the Evans client to play around with the server reflection. Evans is a super cool gRPC client that allows you to construct and send requests to the gRPC server in an interactive shell. There are several ways to install it, as described in this GitHub page. I'm on a Mac, so I will install it by homebrew. First, use brew tab to add this repository to homebrew. Then brew install Evans. Okay, Evans is ready. Now let's start the Golang gRPC server. Since gRPC reflection is enabled on our server, we will run Evans with reflection option. So let's copy this command and run it in the terminal. We also need to pass in the port 8080 of the server. Then here we are inside the Evans interactive shell. We can call shell package to see all packages available on the server. Then use package command to choose a specific package. We can show all services of that package, or show all messages as well. We can use a describe command to get the message format. Now let's choose the laptop service and call the create laptop API. Evans will ask us to provide the data to construct a request. The first field is ID, which we can leave empty. Then the laptop brand, let's say Apple. The laptop name, MacBook Pro. The CPU brand, Intel. The CPU name, let's use core i9. The number of cores is 8. The number of threads is 16. Mean frequency is 2.5 GHz. Max frequency is 4.5 GHz. Next will be the RAM. Let's say it will be 32 GB. Evans allows us to select the enum value from the list, so it's very comfortable to use. Now the GPU. Let's say it's an NVIDIA GTX 2020 with frequency from 2.0 to 2.5 GHz and 16 GB of memory. Since GPU is a repeated field, Evans asks us for more value. If you want to stop, just press Ctrl-D. The next field is storage, which is also a repeated field. Let's say we have a SSD of 512 GB and a HDD of 1 TB. Then use Ctrl-D to stop. The screen size will be 16 inches. The screen resolution is 3072 by 1920. It's not a multi-touch screen, so I'll put false here. The keyboard layout is QWERTY, and it is a backlit keyboard, so let's put true here. Next, the weight of the laptop will be in kilograms, and the value is 2.2. The price is 3000 USD. The release year is 2019. And finally, the updated at field we can leave empty. Now, as you can see, the request is sent to the server, and we get back a response with the ID of the created laptop. Let's try the search laptop API to see if we can find that laptop on the server or not. The max price is 4000. The mean CPU cores is 4. The mean CPU frequency is 2.0, and the minimum RAM is 8GB. Cool, the laptop is found, so the gRPC reflection is working well on our Golang server. Now, let's stop it and try the Java server. Let's click this button to run the laptop server.main. The server is started. Now let's go back to the terminal and run the Evans client. Show package. Show service. And call create laptop API. Evans is asking for input fields, so everything is working properly. And that's all for today's lecture. Thanks for watching and see you soon in the next one.